Well, you may recall 1 year ago, a monstrous superstorm Sandy was forming, preparing to pummel the East Coast.
Yeah, Sandy killed more than 180 people, and it was the second most costly storm in the U.S. history, leaving behind $65 billion in damage. Now, here in Maryland, most of the destruction was on the eastern shore, but there was also flooding and power outages throughout the Baltimore region. 11 News reporter Lowell Melzer is live in Fells Point with a look back, and I think we all remember that storm, Lowell.
Yeah, we certainly do. I do especially. You'll see why in a minute. You know, in the meantime, we were talking earlier, areas like Fells Point, Middle River, Bowley's Quarters, known for their flooding, really were spared from the worst of this storm. As you mentioned, the worst damage was actually seen on the eastern shore in Somerset County. And don't forget, there was also a major snowstorm in the mountains of western Maryland that brought more than 30 inches of snow. To say that Maryland dodged a bullet in Hurricane Sandy is an understatement, especially after looking at the mass devastation suffered in parts of New York and New Jersey. There was a lot of uncertainty as the late October storm made its way through Maryland, which at one point was forecasted to pass right over the Chesapeake Bay. 11 News had live coverage all over the state during the day.
I want to show you how fast these winds are blowing down here. We're seeing wind gusts in between the buildings of about 55 to 60 miles per hour here that I measured on the anemometer.
And at night, where things really got scary.
We showed you out on Coastal Highway. Whoa! Mac, you all right? Holy cow. All right, that's the reason why you're not... There it goes.
In the end, there was a wide array of damage around the state. In Ocean City, part of the fishing pier was washed out, sand was pushed up onto the boardwalk, and debris could be seen everywhere. But residents took it in stride.
Obviously, a lot of debris, a lot of trash, a lot of pickup, a lot of cleanup going to be happening. But all in all, I think we fared well.
In parts of Baltimore City, a number of trees fell on homes, cars, and power lines as winds easily pushed them over because of the saturated ground. Statewide, at one point, almost 400,000 people didn't have power, but it was quickly restored. In another extreme, more than 30 inches of snow fell in the mountains of Garrett County, causing a lot of headaches for residents. But perhaps the hardest hit area in the state was the quiet crabbing town of Crisfield.
We evacuated about 550 people, most of them from low-lying areas.
Following the storm, Mayor Percy Purnell toured the wreckage with Governor O'Malley. Homes were flooded out and the town's fishing dock was severely damaged. While President Obama did declare a state of emergency in Maryland, folks in Crisfield were originally denied individual relief. Hearings were heard on Capitol Hill, and it was eventually changed.
If you live in Crisfield, Maryland, you are suffering as badly as any part or any community in this storm.
Now, in the end, Somerset County amazingly had $40 million worth of damage, and sadly, 11 people died in the state of Maryland as a result of this storm. We're live in Fells Point tonight. I'm Lowell Melzer, WBAL-TV 11 News.